We are still talking about politics. Let's continue our discussion on the 2025 elections as the race heats up. We're now joined by Medal of Valor awardee and retired Marine Colonel Ariel Querubin, who's gunning for a Senate seat next year. Good morning to you, Colonel Querubin.
Yeah, good morning, Karen. Good morning to all your televiewers. No? Magandang umaga sa inyong lahat.
All right, so there's no question you have a stellar track record in the military, but ang tanong ng marami, why join the race in 2025? Sinasabi ng ilan, napakasikip ng karera sa Senado ngayong 2025.
Alam mo, Karen, I've been through a lot of more difficult battles before. And you know, I came out victorious. So, eto no, hindi man natin na kayang matiis ba na nanunod na lang habang nakikita natin kung ano yung nangyayari sa ating bansa. And this is the reason why nung I was given this manifesto of support by around 2000 retired officers, no, senior officers, no, who have served our country with integrity, with they have shown their love for our country so many times over. They said, Ariel, we stand united with you, no, to fight corruption, to uplift the living conditions of the poor, and protect our sovereignty. Oh, sino naman yung Ariel na Ariel Querubin na kung sabi nila, Ariel, matapang ka, bakit hindi mo tatanggapin yung challenge na yun? So I'm now leaving my comfort zone. In fact, I declared last July 8, no, that I'm going to run. Dahil lang sa itong kadahilanan na to, no, ang hirap kaya na pinapanood mo na lang, no, nakaupo ka, pinapanood mo yung nangyayari dito. There's so much energy left in me. And kung ilang ulit na tayo, paulit-ulit na tayo, nagbibis ng buhay, gagawin natin uli yan, no, para sa ating pagmamahal sa ating kababayan, sa ating bansa. So yan ang mga dahilan, Karen, kung bakit ganito tayo ka-passionate na manilbihan uli, no? Iyalay yung ating serbisyo, ating buhay para sa ating bansa.
Oh, now, Colonel Querubin, you are coming out of the private sector. Is that correct?
Yes.
Ang tanong is, why do the Senate first? You could have started, let's say, by running first for many positions. Let's say they could have said, put up a party list group with your passions, or run for Congress, or run for mayor or vice mayor, or even those starting out, they would run for counselor, although some might say you're too old for that. Okay. But then why the Senate right away? Or you could have asked to be appointed to a position, ask President Marcos Jr. to appoint you to a position where they can use your talents and skills. Like, let's say you could have been in the National Security Council. Why the Senate?
Well, I think I can probably give more help to our countrymen being a senator.
Why is that?
National.
But why? Senators legislate. They make laws. What law do you believe are still needed? And what can you contribute? Yes. That you feel you couldn't have done, let's say, with the DNV or the National Security Council.
Well, sabi ko, Karen, no, yung mga bagay kasi na nakikita mo na mas kakayanin mo, no, yung pagbalangkas ng batas, ikinukumpara ko lang yan. Sabi ko nga sa iyo, mas marami kong pinagdaanan na laban. Madali lang ito.
Pero tulad ng anong batas? Batas ang sa palagay po ninyo ang pwede niyong itulong pag kayo'y senador?
Yeah, una-una, no, ang problema natin kasi ngayon, yung gutom, no? Sabi nga, dapat busog ang tiyan. Marami tayong nakatiwangwang na military reservation. Dahil ako sundalo dati, I will push back for the use of all these idle military reservation para pwede nating taniman. Taniman natin, pwede natin lagyan ng ano yan, ng poultry, piggery, even rancho, no? And they can probably put grow o magano no magtanim ng mga high value crops kasi sayang itong mga nakatiwangwang na military reservation. At isa pa no, isusulong natin yung sabi ko nga yan yung ano no, kasi ay yung platform ko is BET no, yan yung busog na tiyan, bigas no, pwedeng ano yan. And then yung edukasyon no, ipapanukala natin kasi ang tagal na natin na ano na nakikita no, na namatayan ako ng mga tao ko, and bigyan natin ng kalidad na edukasyon no yung mga kabataan, at lalo-lalo na yung mga panganay, kasi ito yung tinatakbuhan ng mga kapatid, kapamilya.
Yeah. But do you need a law for this? Do you need a law? For example, it's actually a good idea. I mean, unused land by the military, this reserve can be transformed into agricultural land. I mean, but do you need a law for that?
Yes, I think, because you know what? All of this idle, ano, no, mga military reservation na yan, yung iba na turn over na sa BCDA. But still, sabi ko nga, kahit na sabihin natin na makikiparte kami sa gagamitin nila kasi sa modernization daw ng armed forces yan, still sa dami na nakatiwangwang na mga lupa, no, punta ako ng bukid noon, ang dami nakatiwangwang na ano, I need, kailangan natin lang na magsabatas pa dahil para maklaro, no? At masabi natin kung ano ba yung pwedeng i-ano ng BCDA, ano yung pwedeng maibigay na ano, no? Na maipalis ba or whatever, no?
Okay. Now, you had the written support of 2,000 generals and soldiers all supporting you to run. But it roughly takes at least 16 million votes to get in the Senate today, because we have an increasing number of voters too, right? So let's put it to you, need at least 16 million votes or 15 million votes. Saan po kukunin ni Ariel Querubin ang mga boto na yon? Nag-iikot ba kayo na for so long? Tell me about it. Give me an idea.
Nung ano, no, Karen, nung tumakbo tayo nung 2010, apat na taon tayo nakakulong noon. We had no time, no? Ang handicap natin noon, we were never allowed to campaign, not even once. But you were considered winnable, no? So may mga nakita kami ng mga baluarte namin nung time na yan, na isipin mo, 2 weeks before 2010 elections, you were ranked number 12.
So, yeah, yeah. Ilan ang boto nyo noon, nung 2010 elections?
Well, I'm not so sure.
But you were number 12. Nakapasok ka. That's a survey. That's a survey.
That was in the survey. So 2 weeks before 2010 elections. Tapos may lumabas kasi na propaganda nila, no? No, nalaglag kami lahat eh. So only two of the slate made it, no? But there nung pinag-aralan namin lahat ito, we're doing this scientifically. So may mga areas na dati-dati na mataas na yung naging ano natin, no, yung showing natin. At inahayaan lang namin na binabalik-balikan din natin yan. But yung mga areas, kunwari, na kung saan we didn't do well. Yung Central Visayas, Western Visayas, Eastern Visayas. Makikita ninyo, nung binabalikan ko ngayon, nakaka-very encouraging. Kasi if they see you personally, you shake the hands of people, very very warm yung tanggap nila sa iyo. So eto no, yung Mindanao ko, sabi nga nila pag umikot ka ron, hindi man namin ano yung mga well-meaning friends, some of whom are businessmen na non-partisan, may mga tarpaulin sila, bayani ng Mindanao. So makikita mo na yung Mindanao, ikutin mo lang, marami kang boto na makukuha. Yung 15 million na yan, ang sa akin, it's ano, it's achievable.
It's achievable. Okay. My next question is, are you in good terms with former Senator Antonio Trillanes now?
We have never been ano no, hindi na kami naging nagkaaway o ano, kasi sa Council of Elders nila na tatatlo lang kami noon, eh, ayaw kong banggitin yung dalawa kasi
yeah. The reason I'm asking is in the last few years Trillanes has organized, so to speak, right? He's always spoken about the Magdalo surveys. He's also spoken about how organized they are. So did you ever think that could help you?
Well, ayan, Ana. Sabi ko nga, he called me up yesterday. He said, sir, our group finally decided, yung execom nila, not to go all out kasi ano naman, no? Pare-pare.
To help you.
O
to support you.
Of good governance.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes. So
that is good for you. That's good.
Oh, of course, no. Sabi ko naman yung Magdalo party list ang nag-ano, no? Nag-surface na tutulong. Ang daming mga party list.
Okay, so that's one.
To help.
Another thing is during the last elections, you actually withdrew your support from Vice President Leni Robredo because you believed that she had ties with communist rebels. So do you still believe this to be true, honestly?
Well, ano, at that time kasi meron nagbanggit na, at saka may alam din ako doon, no, kasi I was briefed by the intelligence community about this, no. Well, wala naman ano, no, wala naman, sabi ko nga at that time na lumabas yan kasi I cannot possibly support a candidate that is perceived to be sleeping with my enemy. My track record will show na...
Yeah, but she denied it and we know that's not true.
Oh, well.
Okay.
Yes, we saw each other. Marami na ang occasion kami na nagkita. And alam mo, yung pagkakaibigan kasi I myself, di ba, sabi ko nga sa Congress, eh, I was there. Our enemies, now my friends, because I became a rebel myself. They are no longer ideologues, but they thrive on issues.
Okay, so you have Vice President Leni Robredo who's running for mayor, but at the end of the day, you will be campaigning because you are campaigning for a national post, right? So you still have the group of Leni Robredo. You are carried by the Nacionalista Party, but she still has a national, she does have a national support organization.
Yeah, I agree with that, Karen.
Are you planning to reach out to her, meet up with her?
Definitely. You know, when I said this is now unity beyond politics, no? I am open to joining a group of independents, no? Na nilalagay nila unang-una yung bayan, no? Yung unang-una tinitignan nila yung kapakanan ng mga hirap at mga api. At
so you are open to forming a coalition with Senator Mam Aquino, Senator Kiko Pangilinan, that's what you're saying?
Yes, definitely. These people, no, or my friends actually, we have same advocacies, no? They're decent persons. I don't think, sabi ko nga, kung lahat naging kaibigan ko, napatawad ko na, or those who have wronged me last time, but why can't I, you know, no? Why can't I join common, sabi nga nila, magkakapares naman kayo ng mga...
Okay, so, yeah, I get you. So I want to ask you this. This is a tricky one. Whose politics do you support more? President Marcos Jr. or former President Rodrigo Duterte? Today, because before you actually believed that Leni Robredo was with the Communist Party or had ties. So that was like, as an outsider, to a degree, you kind of fell into the Duterte trap, right? So now it's 2024. The Dutertes also have influence. and they have, on a national scale, they're quite powerful. Which of the two do you support?
I stand with the Filipino people. Alam mo, yung interest pa rin ng Filipino people yung ating ano no, ating susundan. Kasi, you know, politics has become so toxic, so divisive.
That's... Yeah, but standing with the Filipino people, what does that mean? It's vague. So let's say the West Philippine Sea in terms of policy. Whose policy do you believe? Former President Duterte's or President Marcos Jr.? Who do you believe is handling it better?
You know what? Kahit na sino sa kanila.
President, or you don't. So what is it? That's my question. Because those are two presidents with different policies on the West Philippine Sea. So you said that you want to be elected in the Senate because one of the West Philippine Sea issue. So whose policy is better on the West Philippine Sea? Who is right?
Yeah, the current administration has the policy of protecting the West Philippine Sea. Definitely, I am for that.
Okay. So last, I think, do you believe the Philippines is a pawn in the West Philippine Sea issue today? Should the Philippines prepare for war? Is that because you are an expert in this?
I was telling when I'm going around, I'm telling those people I am talking with, I said, when push comes to shove, we must always be prepared. That's why I was pushing for that mandatory revival of the ROTC. Now, alam mo kung minsan nakakaano nga lang kasi ang dami mga politicians ba na sasabi na they will die for our country, they will die. Pag dumating ba yung mga granting lang, no? Yung China, i-invade tayo. Are they willing to die for the country, to die for our countrymen? Sabi ko nga sa kanila, yung Ariel Querubin, di ba? Namatay, ilang ulit, muntik mamatay. All for love of country, all for love of my countrymen. Kaya sabi ko kumisan, ang daming nagpapanggap dyan. May mga kakilala ko na politicians. Eh. Last time, they were pro-China. Ngayon, against China na sila.
Oh, all right. Well, on that note, we don't have enough time, but I do hope you can come back to Head Start to talk about your platform. Anyway, it's a few more months to go before the election, so we still have a lot of issues to talk about. Thank you so much, retired Colonel Ariel Querubin. Do you want to say last words before we go? Why the voters should choose
thank
you?
Thank you first, Karen, for giving me this opportunity. And I also would like to thank all your televiewers. I know you have lots of followers, no? Sabi ko, yung Ariel Querubin kasi hindi siya marunong magnakaw, no? Subok na siya. My track record will show. So sana sabi ko, mahaba pa yung tama yung sabi ninyo. I need to really reintroduce myself because a lot of friends say, Ariel, if people will find out who you are, it easily converts kasi wala ka namang bagahe, no? Maraming salamat sa'yo, Karen, no, for this opportunity.
All right. On that note, thank you very much, sir. Good luck to you. Good luck.